Second important thing, today is an auspicious day for all of us. Why it is auspicious? It is not only auspicious that it is only Hanuman Day, but something more than that. There is a Ram Navami, there is a Ramdas Jayanti, there is a Swami Narayan Jayanti, and our own founders, Dr. Samuel Hanuman Jayanti. He is the fellow because of whom we are here. Because of whom we are giving some service to the better mankind. Because of whom I am someone known to the world in the period of homeopathy. And because of whom we are getting attached. The man who has given a lot to the homeopathy. Whole life to the homeopathy. If you will find it out, the discovery of homeopathy in 1790 and in his last breath in 1843, what he was doing? He was doing experimentation. He was experimenting and experimenting to make the things more and more clear and more true. To show to the world my science is divine. To show to the world my science is not faulty, and that's why he was just working, experimenting and finding it out truth every time, and if anything finds it wrong, then he is taking it away, and that's why there were so many editions of the Organ of Medicine right from 1810 to the 1843 in his last breath, the 6th edition which we are using, it was ready for the publication in 1843. And if you will go through all those editions, then you will find that this fellow has worked together to find it out the truth to the world regarding our science. And that's why this science is the homeopathic science, the divine science. I thank you to the all the people who are gathered together over here and who have worked together for this today's session. I really thank you, Principal Sir, Prachi Madam, Dr. Abhav Sir, he is the senior practitioner in Serampore, and he came over here only to learn some homeopathy. This is something which gives us a strength. Yes, sir, I want to learn in this year, in this age also. So all you are here, and I thank you to all of you. So today's session, I welcome you for the session, Rheumatology and Homeopathic Management. We'll start with the session. This is the divine science. I used to word this divine. Because, why it is divine? Because it contains a dynamicity. The dynamicity which is there inside every human being, it has been stimulated with the help of a homeopathy. It is always from the external mind to the internal mind. It is always from the external mind to the inner conscience to make more and more a man, more and more a human from the man. And that is only because of the homeopathy it is possible. I have presented one case in my blog. If you are interested, you can read that in my blog. My blog is Dr. Prasad, www.drprasadrasa.blogspot.com, and you can see n number of articles, n number of things I have written over there. I have written one case, while I become a Valmiki. And you must read that case from that, and how a person can change from one end to the another end with the help of homeopathic medicine. The person who was tremendously atypical acid flu patient, acid flu made him to become a Valmiki and made a total change in his life. And that's why we used to call this science as a divine science. And today we'll have a practical aspect of it. I used to start my seminar always with the two words. And these two words everyone knows. Ade Satya. Why it is written on the first page by Hanuman, on the first page of the Organ of Medicine? What it means? Yes, I know you are brilliant. They are divine. What exactly it means? You should have a courage to tell whatever you are telling. You are damn sure whatever you are telling, you should not fear when you say something new. In today's seminar, I am quite sure you will learn something, some ideas which are not there in your curriculum. I will suggest you. I have written a post on my WhatsApp group and even on my status that be a Hahnemann. काय म्हटलं तुम्ही हॅनेमन बना असं म्हटलं. आय हॅव फॉलोड हिज पाथ. आय हॅव फॉलोड द पाथ ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन. आय हॅव नॉट स्टॉप टू द 6th एडिशन ऑफ ऑर्गन ऑफ मेडिसिन. आय एम वर्किंग विथ होमिओपॅथी विथ अ डिफरंट आस्पेक्ट. अँड डे बिफोर येस्टरडे ऑन थर्सडे आय वॉज देअर इन सीएमपी कॉलेज. आय मेट द my senior colleague Dr. Devadiga, Prabhakar Devadiga, is the HOD over there, and he said, sir, don't you feel that there should be an improvement in the 6th edition of Organ of Medicine, we should go ahead. Sir, I told him, sir, I used to start with these two words in my seminar, and I used to say, tell all the, whatever the experimentation I used to do in my practice, and then it might be against the Hahnemannian principles also, because otherwise, you are there in the 1843 only. Now it is 2022. You have to go ahead. And if you want to go ahead, you have to work together. The path should be followed in such a manner that you should go on experimenting the way Hahnemann was experimenting. And that's why in today's session, you will learn something more than that which is not yet you have learned sometimes. And that's why there might be questions which will be raised in your mind. My suggestion is that follow whatever I am going to share, put it in your practice, see the result. If you are happy, continue with that. If you are not happy, send me a feedback, sir, it is not working. Sir, tell me the feedback, sir, it is wrong. But I am damn sure, because I am experimenting all those things in the last 30 years. And that's why this is only a good tribute for the Hahnemann on this day, that we should go with the Hahnemannian footstep by experimenting more and more and coming to more and more truth and learn the dynamic science. So we'll start with the session. First important thing, there are many new guys. Number of students are there who wants to practice homeopathy. There are new practitioners in the homeopathy. And what happens, there are different concepts in the homeopathy, other than what he or she learned in homeopathic college. There are many, many concepts. What are those concepts? You might be familiar with these words. There is a sensation method, there is a miasmatic method, there is a genetic constitution, there are keynote prescribers, there are temperament prescribers, there are human symbolism prescribers. When you read all those things, what happens? When you go with these, what happens? It only used to produce one thing in your mind. Then your question arises in your mind. Then what is the classical way? Whether I should go with the sensation, whether I will go with the constitution, whether I will go with the miasm, every time. And that's why a lot of confusion arises over there. So it creates a confusion in students' mind, new pet's mind. The reason behind that is only one thing. Confusion happens because the basics related with the dynamic science, they are not clear in students. This is the dynamic science, and what happens, we used to learn right from the childhood till today, the material science. What we have learned? We have learned the material science. We have not learned the dynamic science. And that's why we know 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. That's what we have learned. And we apply same thing in the homeopathy when we deal with the human being. There are differences between the material science and the dynamic science. If your concepts regarding the dynamic science are clear, then there is no confusion, there is only fusion. And that's why the when you deal with the dynamics, the confusion comes to the fusion. And then you start accepting all the new things in your mind. Automatically it reflects in your mind, and automatically you can understand, yes, this is possible.